Jackal and the Drum. One day, a jackal called Gomaya was very hungry and was wandering about in search of food. After some time, he wandered out of the jungle and into a deserted battlefield. A battle had recently been fought on this battlefield, and the fighting armies had left behind a drum which was lying near a tree. As strong winds blew, the branches of the tree rubbed against the drum. This made a strange noise. When the jackal heard this sound, he got very frightened and thought of running away. "I had better run before I get caught by the person making all this noise." As he was about to run away, he had a second thought. "It is unwise to run away from something without knowing what it is. Instead, I should carefully find the source of this noise." He gathered the courage to creep forward cautiously. When he saw the drum, he realized that it was just the wind that was causing all the noise. He continued his search for food and found sufficient food and water right by the drum. As the wise indeed say, only the brave succeed in life.
The Lion, the Camel, the Jackal and the Crow. There was once a jungle that was ruled by a lion who had a leopard, a jackal and a crow at his service along with many other animals. As was their usual routine, they were wandering about the jungle one day when the lion saw a camel at a distance. This camel had separated from its caravan and was feeding on the green grass of the jungle. The lion took a fancy to this animal that he had not seen before. "Let us go and ask this extraordinary animal where he comes from," he said. The crow, who flies to far-off places, had seen this animal before and replied, "Master, it is called a camel, and this animal lives in villages. The flesh of this animal tastes good. Let us kill it and eat it." But the lion disagreed. "He does not belong to the jungle, so he is our guest. I will not kill him. Please go and assure him that no harm will be done and bring him to me." As per the lion's instructions, they went to the camel, won his confidence and brought him to the lion. The camel stood before the lion and bowed. He also narrated how he had gotten separated from his caravan and how he had reached the jungle. On hearing this, the lion said, "Oh camel, if you return to the village, you will be made a beast of burden again. Stay in the jungle under my kingdom instead. You can feast on the abundant green grass of the jungle without any fear." The camel accepted the offer and they began to live together in peace. Later one day, the lion was severely wounded in a fight with a mad elephant. Such were his injuries that he could not even take a few steps, let alone go out hunting. Due to lack of food, the lion became weaker. The animals who served him were also starving since they were dependent on the lion for their food. When the lion could not bear it any longer, he called them and said, "Go and find any animal that I can prey on, even in my weak condition. This way I can provide food for you and also for myself." All the animals wandered about the jungle to find such an animal, but they were unsuccessful. On their way back, the jackal had a plan. He said to the crow, "There's no point wandering about the jungle when the food is right in front of us. The camel can provide us with enough food for all of us for a long time." The crow replied, "Indeed, what you say is correct. But the master has assured the camel of his safety under his rule. He will refuse to kill him." The jackal said, "Leave that to me. I will influence the master in a manner that he will agree to feast on the camel. You wait till I return after a discussion with the lion." The jackal met the lion and said, "Master, we have been looking all around the jungle but could not find an animal for you. All of us have not had food for so long that we can hardly walk properly. Under this circumstance, if you agree to kill the camel, his flesh can provide food for all of us." The lion disagreed. "Shame on you! How can I kill the camel when he has my assurance that his life will be safe under my kingdom? It is a sin to think like this." But the jackal continued, "Master, it would indeed be a sin to kill him after you have given him the assurance of his safety. But if he offers himself as your food by himself, it would then not be a sin to kill him and accept his offer." The jackal continued, "What good are we if we cannot be of our master's service in his time of need? Please kill one of us for yourself and the others to save the rest of us from dying of hunger." The lion failed to argue with this idea and said, "Please do what you think would be best for all of us." After this, the jackal returned to the other animals and declared, "Our master is sick and weak. If something happened to him, there would not be anyone to protect us. We have failed to find an animal to eat after wandering all over the jungle. The only way now to repay our debts to our master would be to offer ourselves to him. This way, the rest of us would be saved from dying of hunger too. As planned, all of them stood before the lion and bowed. They informed the lion that they could not succeed in finding any animals for their food. The crow said, "Master, we could not find an appropriate animal for your food, so I offer myself. Please eat me to save yourself from hunger." The jackal interrupted, "You are too small to provide flesh for the master. Even if he accepts your offer, it will not be enough for his survival. Indeed, you have proven your devotion, and by offering yourself, you have already freed yourself from the debts of the master." He turned to the lion and humbly said, "Please accept my offer instead. Master, please eat me to save yourself from hunger. If you accept my sacrifice, I will be honored with a place in heaven." On hearing this, the lion shook his head in refusal. This way, all the other animals started offering themselves too, but the lion kept refusing to accept their offers. The camel, who was observing all of this, thought, "All of them speak beautifully about offering themselves, but the master refuses to kill any of them. I too shall seek to impress the master in a similar fashion." Thus thinking, the camel said to the other animals, "You have offered yourself, but the master cannot eat you because all of you are carnivores and belong to the same category as the lion himself. Stand by, for I shall offer myself." With this, the camel came forward and bowed before the lion. He said, "Master, you need not kill any of these animals. Please eat me instead. I offer myself in return for your kindness. I shall find my way to heaven if you may please accept my offer." No sooner had he made the offer than the other animals cheered. Having already been influenced by the jackal, the lion jumped on him. He was killed and eaten by all the animals together. The wise indeed say, "Always be on guard when you are in the company of wicked people. Do not be taken in by their sweet words."
The Cobra and the Crows. There was a big banyan tree where two crows, husband and wife, had prepared a nice nest and made it their home. In the hollow of the same tree lived a black cobra. The crows had a problem because the black cobra would climb up the tree and eat their newborns whenever the female crow hatched her eggs. They could do nothing to save them. The crows went to a jackal who lived in a nearby banyan tree to seek his advice. They said, "Oh friend, it has become dangerous to live here. Please tell us how we can protect our children from being eaten up by the wicked black cobra." The jackal replied, "Please don't give up. Even powerful enemies can be overcome with the use of wit." The jackal told them a plan. "Fly into the capital of the kingdom not far from here. Visit the house of someone who is wealthy and careless at the same time. Notice if something of value is lying around. If you find something, pick it up when the servants are watching you." He continued, "You will need to fly slowly so that the servants can follow you. Return to your tree and drop it in the hollow of the tree where the cobra lives. When the servants reach, they will kill the cobra when they see it." The crows decided to follow the jackal's advice and flew off immediately according to his plan. As they flew above the capital, the female crow noticed some wealthy women swimming in a lake. They had left gold and pearl necklaces on the banks of the lake, which were guarded by royal servants. At once the female crow swooped down and picked up a big necklace in her beak and started flying away slowly. When the royal servants noticed her, they picked up sticks and stones and started throwing them at her and ran to chase her. As planned, she dropped the necklace in front of the hollow of the tree where the black cobra was asleep. She then sat on one of the branches for the royal servants to notice. When the royal servants arrived, the black cobra came out of the hollow of the tree to see what all the noise was about. The black cobra confronted the king's servants with a raised hood, but they attacked him with sticks and stones. They killed the wicked cobra and returned with the necklace. And the crows, having gotten rid of the cobra, lived happily ever after. As the wise indeed say, even a powerful enemy can be destroyed through deceit. The King and the Foolish Monkey. Once there was a king who had a pet monkey. This monkey was a fool, but was treated royally and moved freely in the king's palace. He was also allowed to enter the king's personal rooms that were forbidden even for the confidential servants. One afternoon, the king was asleep while the monkey kept watch. All of a sudden, a fly entered the room and sat on the king's chest. The monkey waved her away, but the fly would go away for some time only to return to the king's chest again. The monkey got very angry and excited. The foolish monkey started chasing the fly with a sword. As the fly sat on the king's chest again, the monkey hit the fly with all his might. The fly flew away unharmed, but the king was severely wounded. As the wise indeed say, beware of a foolish friend. He can cause you more harm than your enemy.
And the wedge. There was once a merchant who employed many carpenters and masons to build a temple in his garden. They would start work in the morning, take a break for their midday meals, and return to resume work till the evening every day. One day, a group of monkeys arrived at the site of the building and watched the workers leaving for their midday meals. One of the carpenters was sawing a huge log of wood. Since it was only half done, he placed a wedge in between to prevent the log from closing up. He then went off along with the other workers for his meal. When all the workers were gone, the monkeys came down from the trees and started jumping around the site and playing with the tools. After some time, one monkey got curious about the wedge placed in the log. He sat down on the log and, having placed himself in between the half-split log, caught hold of the wedge and started pulling at it. All of a sudden, the wedge came out. The half-split log immediately closed up and the monkey got caught in the gap and was severely wounded. The wise indeed say, one who interferes in the work of others surely comes to grief.
The turtle that fell off the stick.
There lived a turtle called Kambugriva in a lake who had two swans as her good friends. All three of them would meet on the banks of the lake every day and exchange stories before returning at sunset. They enjoyed each other's company. One year there was no rain and lake started to dry. The swans got worried about the declining water level of the lake and said to the turtle, "You will not be able to survive in this lake. All the water in the lake will soon dry up." The turtle was aware of the problem. "It is indeed difficult to live here anymore. Dear friends, please look for an alternate lake which is full of water. Then find a strong stick from somewhere. Once you find another lake, you can carry me to the lake with the stick. I can hold the stick tightly with my mouth, while both of you can hold the stick at either ends and fly." As planned, the swans flew to distant places and found a lake which had plenty of water in it. They returned to carry the turtle. They prepared to hold the stick from both the ends and suggested the turtle, "Dear friend, everything seems fine, but make sure to keep your mouth tightly shut all the time. You must not speak or you will fall off." Finally, they started flying. After some time, they had flown some distance where the turtle saw a town below. The people of the town were staring at the sight of two swans carrying a turtle in the sky. "Look at that! This is a rare sight that two birds are carrying a turtle with the help of a stick," they shouted in admiration. On hearing all the commotion, the turtle opened her mouth. "What is all the commotion about?" she asked. Needless to say, she went down the moment she opened her mouth, and the swans could do nothing to stop her from falling down to the earth. As she fell down, the people of the town captured her to make a feast out of her. The wise indeed say, never fail to listen to the advice of your friend.